Hello viewers, and again we look at another theorem. Okay, so in the last lecture we proved that suppose I have a convergent sequence of real numbers, say un, and if there exists a natural number m such that after which all the terms of the sequence are strictly positive, then limit of the sequence un is also greater than or equals to zero. Okay, so now we look at another theorem. Now this is, say, theorem 5, right? Okay. Theorem 4, 4 or 5, I don't know. It may be 5. Okay, whatever. So I'll just write it as theorem. Okay. So the statement is the following. So suppose un and vn be two convergent sequences. Be two convergent sequences of real numbers, of course. Be two convergent sequences. And suppose that there exists a natural number small m such that un is strictly bigger than un. I'm really sorry. Un is strictly bigger than vn. Okay. Un is strictly bigger than vn for all n greater than or equals to m. Then the limit of the sequence un is greater than or equals to the limit of the sequence vn. Okay. What does it says? Okay, what does this theorem says? If you have two convergent sequences of real numbers, and suppose that you can find a natural number m, or suppose that there exists a natural number m after which corresponding to this natural number m, there is a term in the sequence un as well as in the sequence vn, right? Suppose that that term is um and another is vm. This is the mth term of the sequence un, and um is the mth term of the sequence un, and vm is the mth term of the sequence vn. And suppose that after m, if all the terms of the sequence un are strictly bigger than all the terms of the sequence vn. Something like, suppose that these are the terms of the sequence un, say u1, u2, u3, and so on. Suppose that this is my um, this is my um plus 1, and so on. And similarly, suppose these are the terms of the sequence, say vn. Suppose v1 is the first term, v2 is the second term, v3 is the third term, and so on. Suppose this is my mth term of the sequence vn, and vm plus 1, this is the m plus 1th term of the sequence vn, and so on, right? If this is the natural number after which um is strictly bigger than vm, um plus 1 is also strictly bigger than vm plus 1, and so on, right? And so on, then we can say that limit of un is also greater than or equals to limit of vn. Now it is clear, right? Okay. So now let us see the proof. Proof is very simple. Okay. Suppose since un and vn are convergent sequences, so limit of un as well as limit of vn exist. So suppose I call the limit of un as u and limit of vn as v. Okay, and suppose I define new sequence Wn, and I define Wn to be the sequence Un minus Vn. Okay, so the first term of the sequence Wn is nothing but U1 minus V1, which is Un is the first term of the sequence Un, and Vn is this V1 V1 is the first term of the sequence Vn. Similarly, U2 is nothing. Similarly, W2 is nothing but U2 minus V2, and so on. So this is a new sequence, right? Which we are defining using the two sequences, that is Un and Vn. Okay. Then what we can say about Wn is that Wn is a convergent sequence. Wn is a convergent sequence such that Wn is strictly greater than 0 for all n greater than or equals to m, and limit of Wn is same as, we have already proved, right? We have already proved that limit of Wn is same as limit of Un minus limit of Vn. So what is limit of Un? It is U. What is the limit of Vn? It is V. So limit of Wn is U minus V. This is what we have already proved, right? We have already proved. Okay. Why Wn is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than equals to m? Because for every n greater than equals to m, this is our assumption, right? For every n greater than equals to m, Un is strictly greater than Vn. That means Un minus Vn is strictly greater than 0. That's why for every n greater than equals to m, Wn is positive. Terms of the sequence Wn is positive. Okay. Okay. So then again, if we recall our previous result, what it says, if I have a sequence Un of real numbers, and suppose that there exists natural number m such that Un is strictly greater than 0 for every m greater than or equals to n, for every n greater than or equals to m, then limit of Un is also greater than or equals to 0. This is what we already know, right? So Un is a convergent sequence, Wm is a convergent sequence such that Wn is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than or equals to m, right? For every n greater than or equals to m. That means we can apply this theorem and we can conclude that, if I call this as theorem 4, then by theorem 4, I can say that, or by previous theorem, I can say that since Wn is a convergent sequence and Wn, which is and there exists a natural number m such that Wn is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than or equals to m. So by theorem 4, we can say that limit of Wn is greater than or equals to 0. That is same as, what is the limit of Wn? It is U minus V, right? This is greater than or equals to 0. This is U, okay? Because limit of Wn from here is U minus V. This is same as saying that U is greater than or equals to V, right? Because we know that U minus V is greater than or equals to 0 if and only if U is greater than or equals to V, okay? So what is U? U is the limit of the sequence Un. So that means limit of the sequence Un is greater than or equals to what is V? V is the limit of the sequence Vn. So I can write V as limit of the sequence Vn. Right. This proves the result, right? This proves the result. Okay. Okay. So just wait. Okay. So what did we prove? Suppose if I have two convergent sequences of real numbers, say Un and Vn, and suppose that there exists a natural number m such that Un is strictly greater than Vn for every n greater than or equals to m. This is what we already understood, right? Then limit of Un will also be greater than or equals to limit of Vn. Okay, how we proved? Okay, suppose since Un is a convergent sequence of real numbers, hence limit of sequence Un exists, and suppose I call that limit as U. Similarly, suppose I call the limit of sequence Vn as V, because Vn is a convergent sequence of real numbers, and I define new sequence Wn like this, then it is very clear that Wn is a convergent sequence, because since sequence Vn converges, right? Sequence Vn converges, therefore minus of Vn also converges, right? Minus of Vn also converges. So I can say that Wn is the sum of the two, Wn is the sequence which is the sum of the two convergent sequence. So hence it converges, right? It converges. So Wn is a convergent sequence such that Wn is greater than strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than equals to m. Because for every n greater than equals to m, Un is strictly greater than Vn, means Un minus Vn is strictly greater than 0. That means Un minus Vn is strictly greater than 0 means Wn is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than equals to m. And limit of Wn is same as U minus V, because Wn is nothing but Un minus Vn, and hence limit of Wn is nothing but limit of Un minus limit of Vn. So this is true, right? So since Wn is a convergent sequence such that Wn is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than equals to m, right? That means there exists natural number m such that Wn is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than equals to m, right? And limit of Wn is u minus v. This is what we already know. So then by previous result, by this fact or by this result, we can say that limit of Wn is greater than equals to 0. This result says that if I have some sequence, some convergent sequence of real numbers such that there exists some natural number m such that un is strictly greater than 0 for every n greater than equals to m, then limit of un is greater than equals to 0. Right? This is what our previous result says. Using that result on the sequence Wn, right? Because Wn satisfies all the hypotheses which are here in this result, right? So therefore, using this particular result on the sequence Wn, we can say that limit of Wn is greater than or equals to 0. But Wn is nothing but U minus V. Sorry, limit of Wn is nothing but U minus V from here. So I can write limit of Wn is U minus V, which is greater than or equals to 0. This implies that U is greater than or equals to V. This implies that since limit of Un is U and limit of Vn is B, so I just replace the fact that limit of un is u and limit of vn is b. So from here we got limit of un is greater than or equals to limit of vn. This proves this particular theorem. Now let us look at some obvious things which follows immediately from this particular theorem. Okay. So instead of this un is strictly greater than vn, if I have suppose un is greater than equals to vn like this, then also the same thing holds, right? Then also the same result holds. Okay, one can easily show this, right? Okay, so let us try to prove this particular try to prove that also. Okay, instead of un strictly greater than vn, if I have un greater than equals to vn for every n greater than equals to 1, sorry, for every n greater than equals to m, then how we are going to prove this theorem? Let us see. Like before, we defined sequence Wn. Okay, like before, I'm not going to discuss each and everything. Like before, we defined sequence Wn as un minus vn. Okay, then again, since sequence un is convergent, vn is convergent, so Wn is also convergent, right? And such that in this case, instead of Wn is strictly greater than 0, we'll have Wn greater than equals to 0, right? For every n greater than equals to m. Because of this case, right? Un is greater than equals to Vn for every n greater than equals to m, so I can say that Un minus Vn is greater than equals to 0, right? That means Wn is greater than equals to 0 for every n greater than equals to m. Okay? So the only change will be here. So this will imply what? This will imply that limit of Wn is greater than or equals to 0. This will imply that since limit of Wn is nothing but u minus v, right? So u minus v is greater than or equals to 0. This implies that u is greater than or equals to v. This will imply that limit of un is greater than or equals to limit of vn. Very simple, right? Hence proved. Now let us see some corollary of this particular theorem. Okay, so if I have a sequence xn, which is a convergent sequence. Okay, suppose xn is a convergent sequence of points in a closed and a bounded interval. Say AB. And suppose limit of xn equals to c, then c belongs to ab. belongs to AB, right? So what does this particular corollary says? If I have a convergent sequence of real numbers whose points are inside this closed and bounded interval, okay, then, and if the limit of this convergent sequence xn is c, then c will always be in AB, always be in this closed interval AB. Okay, note that every element of this particular sequence should be inside this closed interval AB, right? Then if the limit of this particular sequence is the point C, then C will also be inside AB. How the proof follows? Since every term of the sequence xn lies in this interval, so I can say that A is less than equals to xn is less than equals to B for every n in n, right? So what does this imply? So I can say that limit of A is less than equals to limit of xn by the previous result. This is less than equals to limit of B, right? So what is limit of A? It is same as A. This is less than equal to what is my limit of xn? Suppose limit of xn is C, then I can write C, this is less than equals to B. This implies that C belongs to AB. Very simple, right? Close interval AB. Okay, fine. Okay, now let us look at one note. Suppose xn is a convergent sequence of points. Suppose xn be a convergent sequence of points in an open, instead of closed, if I take open interval, in an open bounded interval, say AB, this is A. Okay, say AB, just wait. Okay. And suppose limit of the sequence xn is C, then C may not be in AB. Okay. C may not be in the open interval AB. So to support this statement, I will give you one example. If I take sequence 1 by 2n, then this is a convergent sequence, right? It goes to 0 as n goes to infinity, right? It goes to 0 as n goes to infinity. How it goes to 0? You can write 1 by 2n as 1 by 2 into 1 by n, right? Now, if you take the limit, n tends to infinity, then 1 by 2 is a constant sequence. It goes to 1 by 2. And 1 by n is a sequence which goes to 0. So 1 by 2 times 0, this will be 0. So limit of the sequence 1 by 2n is 0 as n goes to infinity, right? And this sequence is convergent in the open interval 0, 1, right? This sequence is convergent in the open interval 0, 1, because every term of this particular sequence is in this open interval, right? Is in this open interval 0, 1. But if you look at the limit of this particular sequence, it does not belong to 0, 1. But the limit of the sequence 1 by 2n does not belong to, okay, I'll simplify it, does not belong to the interval 0, 1. Right? So hence, if you have a sequence xn which is convergent, and if all the terms of the sequence xn lies in some open interval AB, and suppose limit of the sequence xn is C, then that C may or may not be in the open interval AB. This is one example, okay? This sequence is convergent in the open interval 0, 1, but its limit is not in this interval, okay? But if you have a closed interval, then in that case, C will always be in AB, in the closed interval AB. That's all. Thank you.